the match between KKR France and Rogerio Bontorin going to happen at UFC 259. Let's put on a brief analysis. Rogerio Bontorin, 5'5", 67 inches is his reach, black belt in BJJ, riding a score of 16-1 no contest. And Bontorin was scheduled to face Manuel Cape, but he pulled out of the fight due to an ankle injury. And looking back at his records, he scored UFC contract at Dana White's Contender Series Brazil 1 in the match against Gustavo Gabriel Silva. He fought in the debut against Magomed Bibulatov on via split decision. Then he TKO'd Haulian Paiva, which was a really, really big upset, but a great, great performance by Rogerio Bontorin. Then he lost to Ray Borg via unanimous decision. Borg missed weight in that fight. He fought in February 2020. And yeah, and in his career, he holds notable victories over Yon Olivar and no contest against Takeshi Kasugai, also against Cristiano Souza, Ivanei Pridonik, Israel Silva Lima. He scored so many submission wins, and Rogerio Bontorin is a typical ground guy. His striking, it's not bad. I can't call it bad, but he is predominantly a ground guy. He is submission expert, outstanding submission expert. His cardio is good also. He only lost once via submission. On the other side, we got KKR France. He is 5'4", and his reach is 65 inches, which means Bontorin is going to have slight reach advantage. On the other side, KKR France is blue belt in BJJ, riding a score 21-9-1. And also, we have the contact here with KKR France. At Glory of Heroes, he defeated Xiao Yoshi. He is a red naked choke. He won. And he fought to judges scorecard or decision in many fights. He outworked Elias Garcia, Haulian Paiva, Mark De La Rosa, Tyson Nam, lost via unanimous decision to Brandon Moreno, and also defeated also lost to Brandon Hoyval via guillotine choke. But got to say that KKR France generally has a very good submission defense. He lost 3 times, but that's not much. I mean, he had ups and downs, but right now he's riding on a great score. He also holds notable victories over Gustavo Falcirovi, Mark Strigel, and also he lost to Tatsumitsu Wada. I mean, he was losing to some really, really big names, but right now in the UFC, he had ups and downs, losing to the best guys in the promotion. So this could be a two-way fight. Either it remains on the feet, or goes to judges' scorecards, and KKR France wins. Either it's gonna be a ground game, and Rogerio Bontorin is going to have an absolute advantage. Rogerio Bontorin stopped Haulian Paiva on the other side. KKR France outworked Haulian Paiva and fought to unanimous decision against Brandon Moreno. So he was facing stronger competition on the other side. Victory over Rogerio Bontorin over Haulian Paiva makes me wonder, man. It really, really makes me wonder. For this fight, I am going to pick KKR France. But I am not 100% sure about this one. It's going to be a very, very close fight. So either the fight goes the distance, either KKR France wins. If the fight remains on the bottom, I think Bontorin wins. He is going to have 100% advantage on the ground. But I'm picking here KKR France.